Feeling the weekend. Brantley Gilbert, Binghamton's number one for new country, 98.1 The Hawk. This is the Hawk Morning Show. Glenn and Traci. It feels like the weekend in here. It feels like a party. And you know why?
Because Kolby Oakley is here.
In the house.
Yay.
Hey, Kolby.
Hi. Hello, everybody.
You can bring that down if you want.
All right.
You
got to
get
the mic a little more.
All comfortable. So Kolby is here. We are Facebook Live right now. So if you're wanting to watch this, waving at the camera. And afterwards, we're going to actually put this up on YouTube. So
all right.
If anybody misses our Facebook Live and wants to see it with
Kolby.
Or
just want to relive it again.
Yes. And again and again and again. So Kolby, welcome. You're kind of like a local legend.
Well, I'm very excited to be back here in Binghamton and obviously on the Hawk Morning Show. Looking forward to playing up here. We've got some shows coming up in the area, and it's gonna be a good time.
It's gonna be exciting. Now, you're from Whitney Point.
Yes, from Whitney Point.
How does a boy from Whitney Point end up in Nashville? Tell us the story.
Pretty much, it's just a long, long car ride is how it starts off, man.
14 hours?
It's 14 hours straight, too. Yeah, so, I've been in the area, and this has been a dream of mine. So, I mean, it was no question. I went down for my graduation party. I decided no graduation party. I want to go to Nashville. Uh-huh. And as soon as I did that, I was like, man, I gotta be down here. So
yeah,
a couple of years later, that's where I'm at.
Was it total and complete culture shock when you went from
a little bit
from Whitney Point in Nashville?
Yes,
you know?
There's definitely I have neighbors now, and there's there's four lanes.
It's built up. Now, one thing about Nashville that I noticed when I was there, everyone is from somewhere else, and everyone has a really cool story. And people seem to, because you're looking for friends, you're looking for someone to bond with. And I find people, at least in my case, very receptive to what I was doing.
Yes, that is the great thing about Nashville. And the funniest part, I know one guy, he's not even from Nashville. He's from Shelbyville, which is just down the road a bit. But I've never met anyone from Nashville, really, in Nashville. But, I've met tons of people from New York. It's amazing how many people, from New York are down there right now. But
that's awesome. So when you first got there, what was the first thing that you did?
First thing I did, I actually was looking up different musicians and just trying, because, I play a lot, and trying to get the band put together out of Nashville, being a new home base.
Yeah.
And then just finding guys who were songwriters and just started meeting with people, just messaging anybody I could. And,
how do you go to Nashville with, did you have a plan or did you just go?
You just show up and go to the Bluebird.
Logistically, how do you do this? Do you have a job outside of performing? I'm thinking if anybody from here wants to go to Nashville, what are you going to do? You go with two pennies in your pocket, or do you have something lined up? What's the deal?
Sure. Well, I personally, I saved up to do it, just to go down knowing that I was going to be out of work for a while. And then fortunately, thank you to the listeners and everybody who come out to shows and allow me and buy my music and allow me to live off of that.
Yeah.
So, I've been very fortunate to have that base going, to where if it wasn't for fans and everybody listening in today, man, that's what drives it for me. So
we are super excited at how, you've progressed, and super excited that you're back, that you would have reached out to us and even considered us to help showcase some of your new music, which is what we're going to do in a couple of minutes.
Yep, Kolby Oakley has a new EP coming out called Where Would I Be? We'll talk about that. We're going to hear one of his singles from it. Very excited. And of course, if you want to Facebook us a question, you can do that too as well.
And we know that we just want to say hi, and we are seeing your comments, and we know the sound is a little bit sketchy. Thank you for telling us about that. We're doing all that we can. And your best girl says hi from Nashville.
Oh, she's already watching. On. All right.
Oh, nice.
She's watching on Facebook.
Good morning,
right
Miss Kate.
Now.
And we want to thank Alex and the rest of the staff for bringing us breakfast this morning, breakfast food and drinks. The Strange Brew at 137 Washington Street, downtown Binghamton, right around the corner from the Hawk Studio. So we need to have you come back a lot more often.
Yes.
They have some awesome.
We'll be visiting for the morning snacks and sandwiches. And
from Strange Brew.
Yes.
Awesome. More with Kolby Oakley, the Hawk Morning Show.